All right, so now we've covered basic digital inputs and outputs, we should take this one step further and start talking about different analog signals. To get a pseudo-analog signal going into this, or really to get a analog signal that we can control and know what the value should be, we're going to start by using a potentiometer. And a potentiometer is really just a resistive band with a wiper that allows you to adjust the output of a signal. So this is what the inside of the potentiometer looks like. There is a resistive track, and we set one side to a high voltage and one side to a low voltage, and then the voltage along that track is a linear function of its position. So if this is 5 volts at 1 and 0 at 3, at this position here it's 5, and then it linearly decreases as it goes down to 0, so it'd be 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0 as it goes down, and then the wiper connects to that resistive track, so that the voltage at 2 is a function of the position of the wiper. So I can vary the voltage at 2 linearly as a function of the position along the track and the input and output voltages. So it's a very, very common control element, and it's easy for us to use as an intro to analog systems, because most of the time when you're doing some kind of sensing, you want to know, you know, not just if something is on or off, but you know what the temperature is, what the position is, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. And most of your instrumentation is going to transduce that whatever the physical system that you're looking at into either a voltage or a resistance, which you can then measure in your microcontroller. So this is a really good intro. Also, the Arduino board itself has a 10-bit analog to digital converter. And so if we do 2 to the 10, there's 1,024 different discrete positions that it can sense. So when you do that measurement, you're not really going to get the value in voltage. You're going to get something between 0 and a 1,023, because that's the 1,024 possible positions, as a function of 0 to whatever the reference voltage is, which for most of the defaults on the Arduinos is 5 volts, although you can set that to something else if you want to. So if we look at wiring up a potentiometer inside our circuit, it looks something like this. I have 5 volts attached to one side of the potentiometer. And again, it just depends on what side you want to be the high or the maximum, and which side you want to be the low or the minimum. In this case, I've set it up so that the low is on the very left and the high is on the very right. Most systems, at least in the US, get larger as you rotate clockwise along the system, so that makes sense to me. I've got my opposite side set to 0 volts, which is attached to ground. I had enough things going to ground at this point that I didn't want to have all my resistors and jumpers connecting directly to ground, so I connected them to the negative line on my breadboard, so all the ones attached to this line here are going to go to ground. And then I have a signal coming from the middle pin off my potentiometer to my analog input A0. Now, it's important that the analog inputs are distinct from the digital pins, because the analog inputs have that analog to digital conversion capability, whereas the digital pins do not. So if you have an analog input, it needs to be on one of these analog input pins to be able to convert that into a digital signal that you can then use in your code. Another thing that we're going to introduce today that we haven't looked at before is using the serial communications, which is again why we're not using this TX and RX pins on our board. We want to be able to use the serial communications via the USB to debug our system and to check and make sure things are working properly. So in the code here, I've not only added a integer for my potentiometer pin, I've also set up a serial command. So this setup command, serial begin, starts a serial communication over the USB, which again is a universal serial bus, at a rate of 9600 cycles per second. So in my command, I have to start that serial communication before I can use that, because it has to basically open the port with the computer before you can send any information through it. Now once I've got that serial started, I can use this serial print line command, which is the println print line. This is the same as print, except for it also goes to the next line after it's done. So rather than having it continue to stream constantly, you get a new line in the console every time, which makes it a little bit easier to read. And what I'm printing is the position of the potentiometer, which I'm measuring using the analogRead command, using the potentiometer pin, and setting that to the integer pot position or pot pos. So when I run this code, it plugs in, and you can see on the serial monitor down here, in the simulation, which again you can just turn on and off inside the Tinkercad system. When I move the position of the potentiometer, the value on the serial monitor changes. And you see it starts off at 1 in this case, probably because this potentiometer is set to not go perfectly to 0, but there's some residual resistance there. And if I go all the way up, it goes to 1022. Right? So that's how this circuit is going to work. So let's look at it on our physical system. So here I've already unplugged my my USB cable, which again we want to do before we start working on anything. I've got my potentiometer from our kit. It doesn't look exactly like the potentiometer inside the system or on the video here, but it does have our three pins. So there's the two reference pins and the wiper pin. So I'm going to go ahead and plug that into my breadboard. And because this one is a little bit too big to have access to the adjacent pins, by plugging it into the middle here, I'm going to put it across the center bar so that way I have access to both the reference pins as well as the wiper pins. I've already moved the ground side of my resistors off of my ground on here onto the negative line on this, but I need to get a couple of jumpers to connect my potentiometer as well as my my reference line to ground. So I'm going to connect my negative line to ground on my board. And then I'm also going to connect the negative or the left side of my potentiometer to that same negative line. I'm going to connect the positive to the right side of my potentiometer. And then I connect that to my 5 volts. Again, I don't have another access to 5 volts here, so I'm going to do the same thing I did with my negative line. So I'm going to go ahead and plug that in there. And then I'll move this 5 volt reference over to the positive line. And I'll get another jumper to connect my LED. Although I'm not using that currently, I'm just going to try and keep that connected. So that way, as I work on this, I don't lose any components that I've already added. That. And the last thing I need to do is I have a signal line going from my potentiometer to my analog input. And since I use green inside the code, I'll try and keep that consistent and I'll use green here again. Oh, I need to go to the opposite side. So that signal pin on this case is on that opposite end. So I'm going to plug that in over here. Look at that and make sure I've got that in the right pin. Looks good. Then I'm going to connect that to my analog A0. Looks like that green line is not quite long enough. You know what? Let's just switch this guy. We'll reverse him to put the signal closer to what I want to get. I've made this upside down now, though. So, well, it doesn't really matter that much. Okay, making sure I've got those connected in the right pin still. And then we'll go ahead and connect this guy to the wiper pin to my A0. That should be good. All right, so I've got everything wired up. Let's take a look at our code. Again, starting from the code I was working on last time, I'm going to go ahead and save this as a new code. So let's look at it as potentiometer serial. So again, I'm going to add that integer for my potentiometer pin. So this is A0. Now when you use the analog read, it assumes, it kind of just ignores the A in this, but it's nice just to have that as a note. So this is the pin for the pot. I need to start the serial communication. I don't need to set the pin mode for the analog inputs because they're default as analog inputs. So that's straightforward there. So serial is the class and then begin is the command. And again, I'm going to use that baud rate, that communication rate of 9600. And again, you always have to have that semicolon at the end of the code. I'm going to leave this code the same because I don't want to modify it. I'll just leave that and it will operate the same just as it was before. And I'm going to do a serial print align. And again, you know you've typed it in correctly when it changes to that orange. It is case sensitive, so you don't get the upper or lower case mixed up. And then what I'm going to print is my pot position. So I'll need to have that defined before I use it. So let's say the integer pot position is equal to the analog read of my pot pin. All right, and let's add some more comments here. So read the position of the pot, display the pot position on a new line in the serial monitor. All right, that should be okay. So let's go ahead and run this. It's compiling the sketch, uploading. Oh, I did it again. Make sure you plug in your board before you upload it. So I've plugged in my board. Check to make sure I'm on connected to the port and using the right board. All right, so now we're done uploading. So again, we didn't modify our button, so our button should still work. We still have this, just go turn on for a second as we press the button. So we haven't changed that at all. That's still wired up. We have our potentiometer here, and this is not really doing anything. But if we turn on our serial communication, so here's the serial monitor, you click on that button. You see we have the value here, and when I turn it, changing values. And you see this one actually here, the resistance at the very beginning and very end is low enough that we do get to a true zero and a 1023, which is the largest and smallest possible values you can get. Now the smallest change we can get in here is actually just one integer, but I don't know if I can control it in small enough movements to actually get one all the way through. Because again, this is a pretty small potentiometer and not terribly sensitive. Another thing we can do with this, if you don't want to display it as this kind of number command, there's also a display that possesses a plot. So you can see here in tools, there's serial monitor and serial plotter. So if you want to plot this as a function of time, you can see how it looks. So kind of fun. And again, if you have an analog signal you're trying to monitor because you're doing some kind of measurement, that serial plotter can show it over time. There's also different functions to actually save these data to like files and things like that using the serial command. There's libraries for those. We're not going to get into those in too much detail in any of the lectures here. But again, if you look through the internet, tons and tons of stuff out there on different things you can use these Arduinos for. You can even build them into miniature oscilloscopes that have reasonable sample rates, you know, which allows you to do a lot of cool kind of signal analysis stuff. All right, next lecture we're going to talk about using the analog to do an analog output, although we don't get true analog output, but we'll save that for next time.